JFD, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for November the 3rd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against the majority of the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian morning Tuesday. It underperformed the most against CAD, Aussie and Kiwi in that order, while it gained some ground only versus the Swiss franc. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the yen and SEK. The strengthening of the commodity-linked loonie, Aussie and Kiwi, combined with the weakness in the safe havens dollar, yen and franc, suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion just a day ahead of the US elections. Indeed, major EU and US indices were a sea of green yesterday, with a positive appetite rolling into the Asian session today. As we already noted, today the spotlight is likely to fall on the US presidential elections. According to national polls, the Democratic candidate Joe Biden is leading incumbent President Donald Trump by around 10 percentage points. That said, the contest is much tighter in battleground states that could decide the outcome. So what are market participants looking in each candidate and what impact the election result could have in the financial world? President Donald Trump has pledged to keep the 2017 corporate tax cuts in place, which could prove positive for US equities. The positive may be true if Biden wins, as the Democratic candidate has called for an increase in taxes on corporations and high-income individuals. However, Biden's spending plans are unlikely to allow a major trend reversal. Perhaps we'll get a correction before the prevailing uptrend's revival. Stocks in the rest of the world may not react in a similar fashion as the US ones. A Trump re-election may result in more trade frictions between the US and other nations, especially China, and thus equities outside the US may retreat in case Trump keeps his throne. Biden is expected to adopt a softer stance on trade, which means that global equities may gain if he is victorious, even if US indices retreat somewhat. In this graph, we can clearly see that US stocks performed much better than their European and Asian counterparts during Trump's term. In the FX world, a Biden victory may result in a slide in the US dollar. Both candidates are expected to push for more infrastructure spending, but Biden's agenda is looser, which combined with an extra commodity Fed may result in some dollar selling. The yen and other safe havens could also slide on expectations of a better handling of international trade relations, while the commodity-linked Aussie and Kiwi could strengthen. The opposite may be true if Trump gets re-elected. Now, in case we get an extended period of uncertainty due to either delays in announcing a winner or even a contested election, remember that Trump said that he may not accept a defeat as mail-in balloting could lead to a voter fraud. So if this is the case, risk assets around the globe may suffer as investors seek shelter in safe havens until we have a clear outcome. Having said all that, the market reaction may also depend on which party will gain majority in US Congress. The Congress consists of two chambers, the House of Representatives and the Senate. And currently, Democrats hold the majority in the House, while the Senate is controlled by the Republicans. Whoever gets elected, a failure of his party to take full control of the Congress may result in a more modest market reaction, as he may not be able to push through with his agenda. For example, if Biden is elected but fails to flip the Senate, stock markets may not slide that much on expectations that Republicans may veto his decision on increasing corporate taxes. Republicans may also oppose his spending agenda, which means a softer slide in the dollar than otherwise. Ahead of the US election, during the Asian morning today, we had an RBA monetary policy decision. As was widely expected, policymakers of this bank cut interest rates to 0.10% from 0.25% and decided to extend their government bond buying program by 100 billion Aussies to buy bonds of 5 to 10 years maturity. The Australian dollar slid only around 25 pips against the US dollar on the announcement, staying among the major gainers in the G10 sphere. In our view, the reason why the Aussie was not hurt much is because the policy actions were largely anticipated, and perhaps because Governor Lowe noted that a negative policy rate is extraordinarily unlikely. All this means that officials are not willing to cut the rates further, and if more is needed, they could boost their bond purchases. For now, Aussie traders are likely to turn their attention to the US elections, with the currency's reaction scenarios already outlined a while earlier. Now, as for the rest of today's events, even though all eyes will be on the US presidential election, there are some indicators worth mentioning due to be released ahead of a potential final outcome. Those are the US factory orders for September and the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week. Factory orders are expected to have accelerated to 1% month over month from 0.7% in August, while, as it is always the case, the forecast is available for the API print. As for tonight, during the Asian session Wednesday, we get New Zealand's employment report and Australia's retail sales, both for the third quarter. New Zealand's unemployment rate is forecast to have risen to 5.4% from 4%, while the net change in employment is expected to show that the economy has lost 0.8% jobs after losing 0.4% in the second quarter. The labor cost index is expected to have slowed to 1.5% year over year from 1.8%. Australia's retail sales are expected to have rebounded 6% quarter over quarter after falling 3.4%. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.